For four prolific years, one of this country's best-loved poets and writers lived and worked in this incredible setting, which inspired some of his best-loved works. But who is he and where am I? Find out in just a moment. On today's house search, our buyers have barely stepped over the threshold before they're planning where to put things.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Oh, you work every detail. You're moving all the new pots and pans.
Well, you've got to think about these things.
And if the kitchen units are the deciding factor in this move, I'm not going to stand in their way.
Am I allowed to start counting cupboards?
Yeah, you count. You count away. I'm here in South Wales, in Larne, overlooking the Gower Peninsula. And it was here in 1949 that Wales's most famous literary son, Dylan Thomas, came to live just a few hundred yards down the road. And it was in this clifftop writing shed with its magnificent views that he was inspired to write some of his most memorable works, including Under Milkwood and Fern Hill. He lived here for 4 years until his untimely death in New York City at the age of just 39. A young life that left an indelible mark on the literary world. South Wales stretches from Monmouthshire near the border with England to Swansea in the west. Across the northern reaches of this region, the lush green valleys and rolling hills of the Brecon Beacons National Park are peppered with traditional cottages built of stone and topped with slate roofs. The landscape to the south levels out towards the coastal plains, which stretch for 168 miles, from Chepstow in the east, all along the Bristol Channel to the Gower Peninsula. It's a rugged swathe of seascape popular with surfers. Since 1956, the geology and wildlife of the Gower have been protected and preserved by its designation as an area of outstanding natural beauty. It was the first place in the UK to be awarded this status. South Wales boasts some of the best of the UK's most stunning natural gems, both inland and on the coast. It's little wonder so many choose this region to seek an idyllic life in the country. It's fair to say Wales offers great value for your property pound. The average price of a detached home here is £225,000. Head to the south, though, especially in the Vale of Glamorgan, and a slightly different picture starts to emerge. You could be paying a premium of £100,000 more for an equivalent property. The reason is beautiful little villages, stunning countryside and an amazing coastline, all within easy reach of Cardiff or Bristol. If you don't have to worry about that commute, though, head to the west in the Gower Peninsula and you'll get equally stunning countryside, but more for your property pound. And that seems to be what's attracted today's buyers to this wonderful corner of Wales. Graphic design manager Steve and wife Wendy have lived in their four-bedroom semi-detached property in Northwood, Greater London, for 23 years. They first met at high school in Northampton when they were teenagers.
I was standing in the French classroom, looking out the window, and I just happened to look down and I saw Wendy walking into school, and I knew there and then she was the one. We went out as boyfriend and girlfriend for quite a while. Then after leaving school, we sort of went our separate ways, and we eventually got back together.
12 years later.
12 years later, and struck up a new relationship, and then...
That was it. Stuck with each other now.
And here we are.
They moved to their current home in 1994 and have seen many changes in the local area during this time.
When we first moved here, it was very much like a village feel to it. We still had a greengrocer's and a butcher's in the little centre of Northwood. It's changed quite a bit over the years. I think the area now, it's just too busy. There are so many more cars on the road. There are so many more people. You get in your car now and you're almost in the road rage before you've got to the supermarket. So we want to leave that behind and find some peace.
Yeah.
Their 27-year-old son, Tom, left home 9 years ago and now lives in Neath, South Wales. Wendy and Steve want to follow him in pursuit of a quieter life.
We're focusing on the Gower Peninsula. It's got some fantastic beaches, great countryside, great walking along the coastal path. It's got such a lot going for it.
Wendy, who lived in Canvey Island on the Essex coast until the age of 10, can't wait to be closer to the sea again.
Yeah, I just want to get down to the beach and walk. In the summer, I want to be sitting on the beach reading a book, and in the winter, I just want to put my wellies on and be walking along the beach with the waves crashing and the rain pouring down.
But it's not just a change of scenery they're after. Although he's not ready to retire completely, Steve is looking to achieve a better work-life balance when they move.
Having worked 9 to 5, 5 days a week, literally every day of my life since I left college, it just feels the right time now to just step back a little bit, maybe work 2 or 3 days a week and spend some more quality time for us.
Have some us time, yeah.
But what I want to do is get back into the arts and crafts that got me into graphics in the first place. I began as an artist, drawing, painting. I even did sculpture and photography. Now I just don't get the time for those.
They're hoping this move will be their forever home, but downsizing is not on the agenda. Steve has a large collection of Batman memorabilia that will be moving with them.
Everybody says, oh, you should downsize and declutter. And we did about 2 cupboards and then said, no, we like everything too much. So we actually need somewhere as big as this to take everything with us.
This is literally sort of up in sticks and just really moving to another place where we can enjoy a better lifestyle. We're just ready for something new and fresh, a different chapter in our lives, really.
In order to find Wendy and Steve a home that's closer to their son, we're house hunting within a 45-minute radius of the town of Neath, in the western portion of the South Wales region. I'm meeting Wendy and Steve to begin our property search in this stunning area. Wendy, Steve, glorious morning.
This is fantastic. Amazing. Absolutely fantastic.
You picked a great part of the world to move to. Why this move now?
Reason number one is to be close to our son, Tom. He lives in the area not far from here, and we want to be part of his life. Whether he feels the same is another question.
And what kind of property are we looking for?
Detached, definitely. Big rooms, preferably. We like light, airy spaces, so feeling of space and freedom, I think, yeah?
Yeah. I know you like the idea of a conservatory.
I do.
But if there's not one, ideally a garden space where we could actually add one later on.
And a bat cave for Steve for his collection.
Tell me a little bit about this.
I'm a keen collector. I've got a big collection of toy Batmobiles. I've got a converted garage, which is full of them, and I need space for them, really.
How many bedrooms for you in addition to this bat cave?
In addition to the bat cave, preferably 3.
And when it comes to budget?
Probably 400 would be our maximum. I mean, if it was a tad over, but it was perfect, we might juggle the figures around a little bit to get the perfect house.
Yeah.
And whereabouts would you like to be?
Well, our son lives in Neath, so ideally within about 45-minute drive of him.
So close, but not too close?
Not too close, no.
No.
If I could have something like this on the doorstep, it would be perfect.
Yeah, pitch a tent here, please.
Well, we may have 3 even more fabulous properties than a tent for you. Yeah. Yeah. But who knows where the mystery property is concerned.
Yeah. Exactly.
Should we get started?
Yes, please.
For their budget of £400,000, Wendy and Steve are looking for a bright and spacious home with a minimum of 3 bedrooms, plus an additional room that can be used for Steve's memorabilia collection. Wendy would love a cosy conservatory or space to build one, and it must be no more than 45 minutes drive from their son and ideally within walking distance of the beach. We have 3 fantastic properties for them to view, but I'll only reveal the price at the end of each house tour. Our final offering will be the Mystery House, which could be their new home in more ways than one. What are you going to be doing with these lovely days that you're going to be enjoying when you move? What extras?
What do you mean? When I'm not walking on the beach.
Oh!
You know those things when you go on holiday, where all those relaxing things, you take a book, you take something to read, your music to listen to, and you just chill out and relax. We're going to sort of swap it around so that we're doing more of that in the week. A little bit of work sometimes.
Oh, I love this.
And
you know, just enjoy ourselves, really.
This is a great next chapter you're about to step into, isn't it?
Oh, I hope so. It should be. It should be.
To kickstart the property search, we're heading to the picturesque village of St Bride's Major, a half-hour drive from their son in Neath. Situated just 2 miles from stunning Southern Down Beach, our first property offering will give Wendy a pleasant 35-minute walk to the sea and access to the Vale of Glamorgan's heritage coastal path, which stretches for 14 miles. The village itself has a shop with post office and a popular pub. Our house is a 5-minute walk from the centre of the village. So come on into the garden.
Wow, this is really cool.
Yeah, I like the garden, sweet. The way it's enclosed.
Yeah, it's really sweet. As estate agents say, it presents well. I've learned that from estate agents lately. It looks good.
Interesting to see how light it's going to be inside.
Yeah. Wendy, I'm sensing you just want to get in there.
Yeah.
Is that, yeah?
Yeah, you want to
okay,
go
OK, come on,
yeah.
Let's waste no time. Let's get straight in there.
All right, yeah. Good.
This handsome stone Victorian property with slate roof was built in 1880, but has undergone renovations and an extension in the last 4 years to create a period home with modern finishes. The entrance hall opens into a larger sitting room. You've got kitchen diner to one side, but I wanted to show you sort of main living room space with those wonderful, peaceful views onto your garden.
Yeah.
That's
really sweet, actually, yeah.
Wendy, you've gone a bit quiet.
I suppose for a lounge area, it's probably smaller than I was thinking of.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, OK.
But then I have been used to open-plan lounge diner, so we haven't actually had a lounge room, have we?
No, this is where rethinking the furniture and all those things. It's going to take a little bit of time, and it will depend on the rest of the house.
This is when you've been worn out by all those beach walks, end of the day.
You've
cooked up a storm. This is your come and sit, put your feet up, enjoy that glass of something lovely. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, I can see that working.
So let's see if we've got that lift space in this house for you. You want that nice open plan. Might be just next door.
Yeah.
Okay.
Excellent.
So come through into your kitchen diner.
This is a nice space. And again, view out to the garden.
Window seat as well.
Window seat, yeah.
Now, Wendy, is this a bit more what you were after? Open space.
Yes, definitely. Yeah, for the two of us, I think this would be fine.
Yeah.
As long as we could fit.
Our table can sit 8 people, and we could do that comfortably in here. Christmases, you know, family get-togethers, friends and things like that, they're important to us.
Yeah.
And this room gives us the space.
Let's just have a look at the kitchen.
OK, yes.
Right,
lovely, warm family feel to this kitchen.
Yeah,
nice work surfaces, actually. I like this. Yeah, lots of storage space. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Oh, you work every detail.
There's an equivalent amount of kitchen space to what we've got. So
you're moving all the new pots and pans.
Well, you've got to think about these things, you know.
Steve's the head, he's counting cupboards. What's your heart saying here?
Yeah, this is OK. I'm not 100% convinced on it, but, no, I think it could work.
I'm seeing possibilities in this place.
Should we see more? Should we head upstairs?
Yeah,
yes.
Absolutely.
Also on the ground floor, next to the kitchen, is a utility area and WC.
A playroom situated in the basement could be the perfect space for Steve's memorabilia collection. Continuing our tour upstairs, there are 3 bedrooms providing ample space for visitors and a family bathroom with separate bath and shower. Not that they need that in the master bedroom.
You wanted an ensuite, didn't you, Wendy?
I did.
Beautiful shower room.
Great.
Okay. She can't resist. It's like, this will be my domain.
No, that's nice. Yes, I like that.
Fantastic use in this room of the church and the village.
And the two windows, which is nice on two sides.
Double aspect.
Yeah.
Yeah, over across the roofs, across the trees. This is a nice room, actually. Yeah, I'll fight you for it.
Outside, beyond the Wendy House, there's also a useful garage block and private parking area. The garden lies to the front of the property, and it's mostly lawn, but also has a pleasant patio space.
Lovely secluded garden.
I do like the garden, it's really nice.
Yep.
Time to talk money.
Yeah.
What do you think it's on the market for?
Heart says 385,000.
I think maybe £405,000.
Really?
The property's currently on the market for £400.
Right.
And £25,000.
Right, okay. Wow. Right, yeah.
Shows what I know then.
Yeah.
If they are willing to stretch their budget that bit further, this detached Victorian property offers Wendy and Steve a lot of options. Although not open plan, it does provide plenty of living and dining space and meets their requirements with four bedrooms. In addition, the basement allows ample scope for Steve's collection of superhero memorabilia. All this is just 35 minutes walk to the beach and a half hour drive to their son, Tom.
I think the location is great and its proximity to the beach is definitely a plus point for us. And the house initially, when we first arrived, really did seem to present well. You know, first impressions were really good.
The kitchen, the dining room, I think is lovely, and the whole house has got a really nice, friendly feel to it. I think I'm struggling a little bit with the fact that the lounge area is quite smaller than I'm used to now.
We'd be rethinking the way our rooms are laid out at the moment. It'll be quite a challenge, I think, for us to sort of think about how our furnishings and things fit into this property.
It's the sort of place that I would go on holiday and would love spending a fortnight in. I'm not sure. I need to think about it a bit more as to whether I could actually see myself living here.
So, good start?
Yeah, very good start. Yeah, interesting house.
More to see, come on.
Right.
Wendy's fond childhood memories of living by the sea in Canvey Island have given her a real zeal for coastal life. Husband Steve is also looking forward to this change of scenery as an opportunity to pick up his sketch pad and pencils again after many years. We've sent them to meet Gower coastal guide Dave Tong. The first adventure on their journey around this stunning coastline is wading out to the boat.
Dave.
Hi.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Hope you've got a good adventure for us.
Dave, nice to meet you.
How are you doing? Nice to meet you.
Permission to come aboard.
Big step up, yeah. Hop aboard.
Thank you.
Dave has been running tours around the peninsula for 14 years.
So what's so special about Gower Peninsula?
Everything's special about Gower. It's got beautiful beaches, beautiful coastline, lots of wildlife, really nice place to
perfect
live.
Perfect place to live.
Yeah, perfect. All right, I'm going to get us going.
OK.
Grab a seat. Enjoy the ride.
Thank you.
Cheers, Captain.
OK, so we're going to head down to Worms Head first. It's low tide, so let's get going.
Great.
The stunning Gower coast is comprised of limestone cliffs, rocky coves and sandy beaches that attract a broad range of wildlife. Around 5,000 Atlantic grey seals live on the shores of southwest Wales. They survive in these parts without predators, on a diet of small fish, including sprats and sand eels. Their sensitive whiskers detect vibrations that help them to catch the fish they eat. Seabirds, including guillemots, kittiwakes and razorbills, can also be found along this coast as they rest in the cliffs.
So, what are we seeing now, Dave?
Oh, we've stopped to show you Paviland Cave. Uh-huh. It's actually a very famous cave. Back in 1823, they made an amazing discovery. They found a human skeleton. It's quite a small skeleton, and it was stained red. When they first examined it, they thought it was about 2,000 years old and a female, so it was given the name the Red Lady of Paviland.
Right. Wow.
Since then, technology has improved. Yeah. The bones have been re-examined, carbon dated, back to a staggering 34,000 years old.
Wow.
Wow. Yeah.
That's a bit different to 2,000 years.
And it's actually a man, yeah?
Oh.
They now think that he was a caveman that lived in and around this area. The skeleton had a shell and bone necklace with it and a mammoth skull. They now think he was a leader of a tribe of cavemen that lived in and around this area. So it's actually the earliest known ceremonial burial site of a human being in the whole of Western Europe. It was found in that cave right there.
That's fantastic.
The skeleton is now conserved at Oxford University, and the nearby Swansea Museum houses an exhibition about the find.
OK, guys, we're going to head back to Oxwich now. I hope you've enjoyed your trip with us.
It's been fantastic.
It's been fantastic.
Yeah, really appreciate it.
We'll be back. We want to do it again,
thanks,
definitely.
I'll see you again. Good luck with the house hunting and enjoy Gower.
That's great. Thanks so much,
Dave.
Cheers,
guys.
The tour has given Wendy lots of ideas for the wildlife she'll see on her regular coastal walks and plenty of inspiration for Steve's art. Here's hoping they'll be locals when they make their next visit.
To show our buyers what life on the Gower Peninsula could be like, we're heading to Oxwich for our next house. The pretty village has an active community, and the local restaurant is popular with tourists and residents. But the star feature of this location has to be its 2.5 mile stretch of beach. It's popular for water sports and is situated on the Gower Coastal Path, a 38-mile route which takes in the bays and coves of this stunning peninsula. It's a spot that Wendy already knows and loves from previous visits to their son, who lives a 45-minute drive from here. So I'm hoping the fact that our second house is just a 10-minute walk from here goes down well. Property number two.
Okay. Very pretty.
It is really pretty.
Well, I know you don't like much of a garden.
No,
so
that's
we've got
true.
Just a little, just enough.
Yeah. Okay.
But little chickens if you want
okay.
to keep busy.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
The house was built in 1990 by the current owners.
1990?
Yep.
Okay. It's not that old then.
So they've purpose-built this. They wanted to design a really warm, welcoming
All right.
home.
All right. Good.
Even though it's only built, you know, 1990, it's got a cottagey sort of feel about it.
Should we get in there?
Absolutely. Yes, please. Yes, yeah, lead on. Hello, chickens.
The exterior of this detached property certainly belies its age. With its traditional slate roof, it looks very much at home in this Welsh coastal village. As we go inside, along the entrance hall, is a large living room. So come round, then you can take in sort of living room on this side.
Yeah. Right.
And then they've opened it out.
This is the same way around that our house is now, with a living room all through to the dining room. So this feels more natural. And obviously you can close it off if you wanted to, with the double doors there.
Does this feel the kind of shape you're more familiar with?
This is more, it's definitely more familiar with, and I think it's probably more what I actually want.
OK.
In truth.
Good.
Steve, are you measuring as you go here?
You know, you... yeah. All the practical things are going to be down to me. So as long as Wendy feels happy, I've then got to make it work.
OK, well, let's see if the kitchen is it has
Absolutely.
That same feeling.
Yeah. Yeah.
Come this way.
Certainly a good start, though, yeah. OK.
Ah.
All right,
it's not
OK.
That bad size, is it?
Am I allowed to start counting cupboards?
Yeah, you count, you count away.
There's plenty of space here, lots of space.
Yeah.
Even a little breakfast bar like we have at home now.
So this works for you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, I think upstairs you're absolutely going to love.
OK.
OK.
This way, okay. Come on.
Go.
The ground floor of this property also benefits from a utility area complete with WC and shower. Upstairs, there's a family bathroom and three bedrooms, all of which are a good size. The largest is currently used as the master.
This is nice.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Enough wardrobe space?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah, this is great. This is a good size
a nice
double room,
isn't
actually,
it?
Yeah. This is a really good room.
And there's an ensuite there, Wendy. And you've always wanted an ensuite.
I do.
Go and have a look at that. Just have a, have a little look.
Oh, my goodness, this is definitely what you would call an ensuite bathroom.
Wow. This is another bedroom.
This is amazing.
This is rather large,
isn't it? It was actually a bedroom.
You could lose somebody in here.
So that's your little dream for you.
That definitely ticks the ensuite bathroom box, doesn't it?
Absolutely.
Now, you wanted a back cave, didn't you?
I need space still for my back cave,
okay.
Yeah.
Up in the eaves is a large space used by the current owners as a study.
Another level.
OK, Steve, I have to admit, this I'm thinking is your dream back cave. Would this work for that collection of yours? Oh?
Not easily.
Oh, no,
not
why
easily.
Not?
Easily. The cabinets are about this high, so I can't get them on the sides.
You could have different cabinets.
Yeah, it could go long.
They could go long ways.
Yeah.
Of course.
I've got to do some measuring.
but
this is a great space.
This is a lovely
space. This is a really nice space.
I know you like to entertain. Sometimes you have a lot of family, friends over.
Mm, yeah.
You could...
This has got lots of...
..get an extra sofa bed or two up here.
You could sleep dozens up here.
Good, there's room for me when I come to stay. With lots to think about indoors, I think it's time to see what's on offer outside. Come on out. The rear garden is largely paved and has plenty of entertaining space and a large pond. The property also benefits from its own garage. So lots to take in when considering the price on this property and the gorgeous area it's in as well.
Absolutely.
What do you think it's on the market for?
I'm going to stick with my 385,000 that I had the first time.
I'm going to go a little bit higher, I think. £395,000.
One of you's exactly right.
Oh.
That'll be you.
Actually, this time it's you.
Really?
This house is on the market for £385,000.
That's good, because that's below our target budget, mm-hmm. and that might give us a little bit of money to play with.
Well, now you know the price, and that it gives you a bit of wiggle room.
Yep.
Why don't you have another look around and plan where that back cave's going to go? And then we'll have a catch-up after.
Cool.
Not gone surfing, so...
On my beach.
Yeah, on your beach. Go and have another look.
Thank you.
Coming in £15,000 under their top budget, this modern detached property fulfills their wish list with spacious living areas that open onto each other and four bedrooms, including that loft space, which could be perfect for Steve's memorabilia if he's prepared to remodel his existing display cases. Located just under a 10-minute walk from the beach, it also benefits from being in the heart of a popular village.
The location is perfect. I mean, to be this close to Oxwich Beach, which is just the most beautiful beach I've ever seen, I think. So, for me, this is absolutely spot-on location-wise.
There's also some fantastic walking, literally, from here. It's got lots of things going for it. The rooms are good shapes here, more practical sizes and shapes to work with as bedrooms. And I think a degree of flexibility, because, obviously, where the bedrooms go, where my back cave goes, it's not going to fit into every house easily, but here we seem to have some options. Mm-hmm. So I think that's important.
Oh, quietly optimistic.
Absolutely.
On this one.
Yeah, this is a good one.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hi.
Have you had a look where you're going to spend that wiggle room money? Got a few ideas.
Yeah, lots of ideas.
A good first day.
Yes.
Yeah, absolutely. Seen two really good houses, but this one's got a special feeling at the moment.
Need a little refreshment, light refreshment after
that
a day of house
good.
Hunting.
Yes.
Come on.
I'm property hunting in South Wales with childhood sweethearts Wendy and Steve, who currently live in Northwood, Greater London. They have £400,000 to spend on a property that brings them closer to their son and the coast. Coming up, a bedroom at the Mystery House offers more than just sweet dreams.
To wake up every morning and see that would be amazing. You couldn't have a bad day.
And I head to a unique spot on the Gower to discover how this landscape is farmed.
Flip, away. They're ready
then
to go.
They know what their job is, don't they? Yesterday, we showed our buyers two fantastic properties, both close to the coast, which is a lifestyle they seem increasingly attracted towards, and both with plenty of space. Although finding enough room for Steve's back cave is proving a tough nut to crack. So on to today and the Mystery House. Well, I'm glad to say it's brightening up because that will really showcase one of the most spectacular aspects of the property. And it's a house that's also going to test just how open Wendy and Steve are to living in a different style of home.
For today's mystery property, we're heading to the Vale of Glamorgan and the coastal village of Ogmore-by-Sea. Surrounded by green rolling hills, Norman-built Ogmore Castle lies on the edge of the village. Built in 1100, the original structure had three stories and would have been 40 feet high. But it's the expansive beach here that attracts tourists and is loved by locals. It's not only a beautiful spot to live in, but convenient too, with a village store, cafe and craft shop. Our mystery house is situated on a modern development just 5 minutes from the centre of the village.
Here we are. This is your mystery house.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
Now, you said you're open to styles and location.
Yeah. And location.
Open-minded, yeah.
So, your mystery house was built a year ago.
Oh, wow.
Okay, right.
But what are your initial thoughts?
It looks really smart, actually.
Yeah.
New houses.
I like the colouring on it.
Ready to go, no need to lift a paintbrush. That's so lovely. Outside, looking good?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Very smart, very presentable. Yep.
Okay, shall we get inside?
Yes, please.
Come this way. The front door of this new build mystery property opens into the entrance hall.
Come on through.
Through to the left is a high-spec kitchen diner.
Wow.
Ooh,
that's wow. A view.
Straight out there to take the view in.
This is a lovely room, isn't it?
That's the aspect that I think that makes this
really
house
cool.
So special.
That is really cool.
That is, yeah. That's spectacular, view, isn't it?
Yeah, that's amazing. Really lovely, bright, white room, clean, fresh. Yeah.
It's a gorgeous room, but you almost can't take your eyes off the view.
It's lovely, yeah.
So this is almost my conservatory, but...
Well, it's a bit, yeah. It's like it's been extended out, like a mini conservatory. But to sit and eat and look out onto that... I think everybody would just sit around the table and just sit and look out the window.
Nobody would be talking, we'd just all be staring at the view.
Yeah, just looking out to the sea. Yeah, that is something special.
Just around the corner, there's utility space, so washer, dryer, cupboard space, storage around there as well.
Great. Right. There's properties go, this is a great selling point. Yeah. And this was a real surprise.
Shall we see more?
Oh, we need to.
Okay, come this way. Come
A well-appointed cloakroom is situated by the front door, and across the mystery house's entrance hall, the living room.
Wow, this is a nice side room too, actually, yeah. This is a good room. And three windows in a room. That's really quite unusual, yeah.
Well, you can actually see the sea from that.
Right. So technically, you can see the sea from the back and from the front.
Yep.
Wow, it's like living on an island.
This is your new life. This is your escape.
This has got stuff going for it.
Shall we see more then?
Cool.
Yes, definitely. Please.
Okay, so downstairs is winning.
Downstairs is definitely.
Let's see if upstairs does the same. Come on.
Great. Right. Okay.
The mystery house is certainly going well so far. Upstairs are two double bedrooms for guests, a box room, and a modern family bathroom. To the front of the property, another room with a view.
This would be the master bedroom.
Oh, absolutely.
With that view.
Oh, absolutely.
Okay. Wow.
That is beautiful.
Is that making you a little emotional?
It is, actually. Yeah. That is an amazing view.
Yeah.
But to wake up every morning and see that would be amazing. You couldn't have a bad day if you wake up and you look out of that, could you? Because it's just going to set you up for everything, isn't it? And the fact that you can walk all along there as well, and it's on the doorstep.
I can get the paintbrushes out and the sketch pad out just here. I don't even have to go outside.
Sit in bed and do it.
Sit in bed and sketch, yeah.
And you've got your ensuite, which you really wanted.
Oh, here we go.
A couple of the properties in the development have put a staircase up into the attic space. You've got the full height there.
Oh, really?
Oh, right. Okay.
Created a master suite up there.
Okay.
And then you have a couple of big doubles as well. Mm. Does one of those become...
The Batcave.
Dun, dun, dun. Flexibility. Like it.
So, again, you've got some options here. Yeah.
Although the mystery house doesn't provide space for Steve's Batcave yet, it doesn't seem to be putting him off. Outside, there's a patio and lawned area that are perfect for enjoying the incredible views on offer here.
Wow, look at that. Fantastic.
So the garden, you didn't want too much garden.
No, this is perfect size, actually, for us.
Yeah, it's a good size.
Really good size.
But we can do things with it. It's sort of a blank canvas, isn't it, almost?
Yeah, perfect. But this stone wall is perfect.
It is lovely that they've kept that character, and yet the house is brand new.
It's brand new,
yeah.
No work to do, and nice to take a view of where you might be out on that bodyboard a little bit later.
Well, yes.
Shall we talk money?
Okay.
Oh, if we have to.
What do you think it's currently on the market for?
Oh, wow. This one is really difficult.
I think probably this is about 420.
I'll go a fraction lower.
OK.
I'm going to go for an even £400,000.
This property, our mystery house, is currently on the market for £364,995.
OK, we'll take two. Wow. With that view?
With that view.
I wasn't expecting you to say that.
Well, with all that to think about and the price to have a think about as well, why don't you have a look at the house again?
Yes, I think we need to.
Miss, please.
And work out where you could be spending some of your extra budget.
Cool.
And I'll catch up with you in a bit.
Great. Cheers. Thank you.
Well, it looks like the mystery house and that spectacular view has worked its magic.
Coming in under budget by just over £35,000, this modern mystery house has the spacious kitchen diner and bright living room that Wendy and Steve were looking for, with the added bonus of a stunning sea view. Although it doesn't quite meet the requirements in the bedroom department, the scope to extend into the loft is achievable to create a bat cave for Steve. And all this is set in an enviable location, close to the beach and in a beautiful village.
When we first got here, it was like, ooh, okay, is this what we were expecting? We've kept our mind completely open. So seeing a new house was never off the cards. Once you get inside the house and you see the view and you see the location and where it sits and what you can see, really, we fell in love with it almost immediately.
The kitchen is fabulous. Really like the kitchen. I can just imagine all the family crowded in there, everybody cooking, drinking, having fun. It was just, it felt right. I really wanted the conservatory, but I don't even know whether you'd need this here because the way that room is designed, it's almost like you've got a conservatory built onto it with all the light and everything coming through. So, yeah, it's a good find.
The price was a really pleasant surprise. You know, I'd pay more just for the view. We were just bowled over by that, really.
Hi. Oh, still big, big smiles. Lots to talk about.
Absolutely. Lots to think about.
Let's find somewhere to have a little refreshments and a chat.
Good idea.
Come on. Please.
The Gower Peninsula is perhaps most famous for its beaches, but its northern shores present an altogether different landscape. All along the Bury estuary are salt marshes abundant with samphire, sorrel and sea lavender. The tide floods this entire landscape every 2 to 3 weeks. But for third generation farmer Dan Pritchard, it's still a prime spot to graze his sheep. I'm meeting him today to discover how he farms on this special landscape.
Dan, this is an incredibly beautiful place to come to work. You must love it every day.
Yes, it's really nice to come out, yeah, especially when the sun's out.
How much space am I looking at here? Because I feel like I almost can't see the end of your land here.
They say there's about 4,000 acres.
Okay.
I'm not one to measure or to argue with what that is. Yeah, we have 1,000 ewes and they cover pretty much the whole area. So it is a bit of a job to get them in when we need them.
How often do they come in?
The tide's in probably every 2 to 3 weeks. So we know when it's coming in, so we plan a couple of days before to get out mob-handed and to get everything in.
The meat you get, it's really popular in France, this kind of salt marsh lamb. And how's it taking off in Britain?
It is gaining popularity every year. Every year we notice the orders coming in a bit quicker. And hopefully it'll continue.
And how is the flavour different?
Because of the herbs that they're grazing, obviously the different diet means a different flavour of the lambs, and yeah, they eat as much as they want.
So is this what makes your lamb so special?
Yep, there's a lot of salt-tolerant herbs here in all this, but the main one would be samphire, which is this one. And it is a very salty taste, but you could eat it straight off here, really. Just pick a bit off.
It's really... I love that. It's really fresh.
Yeah, really fresh.
1 E5 a day.
Yeah, it must be, yeah.
So this is what they're grazing on?
This is one of the herbs they're grazing on day in, day out.
When the tide is due, Dan must bring in his entire flock. It takes a whole day for him and his dogs to round up the sheep and get them to the safety of higher ground.
Away, Lib! Away!
The uneven terrain here is a challenging landscape, and he must ensure that all his sheep are accounted for.
They know what their job is, don't they?
Lib! Lib! Away!
And they've already started moving.
Yeah, they're starting to come in slowly. We've just got to get the ones right at the end.
How many animals are the dogs now controlling?
Probably coming in from this way is probably 300 in total, or coming in from this side. Come on, girls, in you come.
I can barely see what they are just at the end there, but they all seem to know. Okay.
Only when the tide has subsided will the flock be released back down to the lower marshes. The nature of this landscape makes it an intensive plot to manage. So after a hard day of labour, it's time to sample this season's new batch of lamb.
And where better to enjoy this than at the farm's very own castle?
It's a busy day at work and then...
Busy day and now we're having the rewards afterwards.
The smell is phenomenal. I'm drooling. Yeah. I'm not sure where I'm going to start.
Well, they're all for you.
As the provenance of the food we eat is of increasing importance to consumers...
Oh, my goodness, that is good. So juicy.
It's fascinating to gain an insight into the knowledge and commitment required to farm in this unique landscape.
Well, great reactions to the Mystery House, but they also loved property number two. So I have to admit, I'm really unsure about which one they're finally going to plump for. Wendy, Steve, I am dying to know, where are you now? Because it's been quite a week.
Our heads are spinning, aren't they?
Yeah, it's been a real journey. The Mystery House was a real surprise. It probably wasn't what we were expecting.
No, not at all.
There are so many great things about that house, things that we really love. And they're totally different things that we love in the second house, hence the dilemma.
So the problem is, we've given you two houses that you love.
Yes.
Yeah, you really have.
Yeah. And we weren't even sure you'd find us one. So yeah. You've given us a headache.
We could actually probably live in either of those two houses. And I think that's what's given us the problem.
The downstairs of the Mystery House was perfect. I don't think we would change anything. But the upstairs, there's still a bit of a problem with the bedrooms and the back cave. And I think we need to sit down and get some pencil and papers out and draw things and see
do
what
some
we
measuring,
do.
Proper measuring, yeah. And sizing up.
Do you both love Property Two and the Mystery House equally?
I'm very, very drawn to the location of House Number Two. That's a very big pull for me because you know it was important for me to be near the beach. I like the space in the Mystery House though.
I could see us moving straight in there. I can see all the furnishings fitting in there really quite easily with very little to do.
So you've got two great locations. And two great properties. What's going to be your next step?
I would really like to organise a second visit to both of those two houses with a fresh approach.
I can't wait to see where you end up, which property you choose.
No. Nor can we, can we?
No. We're still excited by both of them.
Yeah. But I'm thrilled that we found you two properties that you love. Do let us know how you get on and where you finally make your new home.
We will do. Indeed. And you'll be welcome anytime.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
It's been an absolute joy house hunting with Wendy and Steve this week. It's the first time they've looked at properties in over 20 years. Wish them all the best with those all-important second viewings, and hopefully it won't be too long before that back cave has a new home. I'll see you next time on Escape to the Country.
If you would like to escape to the country in Wales, Northern Ireland, Scotland or England and need our help, you can apply online at bbc.co.uk/beonashow.